Now, after listening all these things, we are also very much interested. Yes, how to abolish them? Maybe slowly, maybe in the reverse process, but how? So in Sutra number 11, Patanjali gives a small hint for that. It's not the total action I am saying about, some hint. He says, Dhyana heya tad vrittaya. Tad vrittaya means those nature of those kleshas. And dhyan means meditation. And heya means to abolish. So all these kleshas can be abolished, maybe slowly, in the reverse process, with the technique of meditation. Now he uses only one word, dhyana. With that only one word, we cannot get the total process. But that total process Patanjali is going to explain afterwards. But he is preparing our mind for listening and learning and practicing the total yoga, preferably the Ashtanga yoga, which all of us know very well. So Patanjali is approaching to this stage of Ashtanga yoga, and then he is explaining Ashtanga yoga. But here he is giving only one word, that dhyan meditation. But meditation needs so many things. Meditation is one of the component of Ashtanga yoga, and which needs. Actually, dhyan is seventh component. But for dhyan, dharana is essential. And for dharana, yama-niyamasana, pranayama, pratyahara is essential. Like that, total Ashtanga yoga is essential. But he is mentioning only in one word, just to give us some clue. Yes, there is a way and means to abolish these kleshas, and that is represented by dhyan. So now we have become very much interested in knowing what is dhyan and all that. Let us see. We'll see afterwards. Hari Om.